China leads the world in having the most electric vehicles, or EVs. The Biden administration is pushing for half of new car sales to be electric by 2030. However, American consumers need to be aware of the risks associated with electric cars. And there's a lesson or two we can learn from China's rush to new energy vehicles. Hi everyone, welcome to my show, I'm Lei. Before I begin, I'd like to tell you that I want to have a chance to answer your questions. I know some of you have questions for me or things you'd like me to address. Please leave me comments. I'll address them in the next couple of videos. EVs are getting a lot of hype, but we can't ignore some very basic safety and environmental concerns they present. Recently, GM announced spending $800 million to recall its Chevrolet Bolt EVs after at least two of the vehicles burst into flames. Hyundai is spending $900 million for a recall following fires in 15 of its Kona EVs. Ford spent $400 million last year recalling about 21,000 plug-in hybrids, Kuga, and suspended sales due to concerns about batteries overheating. And then there's BMW, Volvo, and the list goes on. Lithium-ion batteries, which power electric cars, are also used in mobile phones, tablets, or other household electronics. They can be extremely volatile if damaged and would explode if they are punctured, subjected to pressure, or if there are quality issues. Take a look at this video when a man tried to install a faulty cell phone battery. Compared with a cell phone battery, the battery of an electric vehicle is extremely powerful. It's equivalent to the electricity used by a family for 2 days. These batteries are divided into many small cells and are managed by software that keeps the battery running smoothly. But if the software malfunctions or if a car crashes and some of those cells are damaged, the chemicals inside can generate huge amounts of heat, damaging and igniting other cells. If a fire erupts, it's not only deadly but also difficult to put out. According to the U.S. National Transportation Safety Board, lithium batteries can reignite up to 15 times after the fire is extinguished. In the case of the Tesla Model S fire in Texas this past April, firefighters put out the fire with 106 tons of water. Generally, fuel vehicle fires need only 1 ton of water to extinguish. The Washington Post reported that Yugi and Caroline Vingdom's Tesla Model S burst into flames while being charged in their garage. Because of its high temperature, the fire triggered another electric car parked nearby to catch fire. Yugi Vingdom said, "If we had lived upstairs in this house, we'd be dead." Tesla claimed that its cars are a tenth as likely to catch fire as gasoline vehicles, but admitted that fires in EV cars can burn more intensely and last much longer. Its website says that battery fires can take up to 24 hours to extinguish. I looked into comparisons of accident rates between the number of fires in EVs and gasoline cars, and found one study based on 4.6 million gas car or gasoline cars and 50,000 electric vehicles in London. Based on 54 EV fires and 1,898 gas fires that the London Fire Brigade dealt with in 2019, Fleet Auto News reported that the EV fire incident rate was 0.1%, more than double that of the gas vehicles at 0.04% in London. This number is likely to go up as more electric cars age. As automakers compete to make electric vehicles more powerful with longer driving range, the chemical cocktail they put into the battery becomes more potent and raises more concerns for safety. Wu Feng, a professor at the Beijing Institute of Technology, said that a 20-gram or 0.7-ounce lithium cell phone battery can pollute the amount of water equivalent to three Olympic-sized swimming pools. If discarded on the land, it can pollute 1 square kilometer or 247 acres of land for 50 years. Just imagine the environmental risk when millions of EV cars retire their 1,000-pound batteries. EV batteries contain heavy metals such as cobalt, nickel, and manganese. Take manganese as an example. It pollutes the air, water, and soil. If you drink water with high manganese content, your central nervous system will be damaged. Another major pollutant in lithium-ion batteries is the electrolyte, which is not only flammable but can also produce hydrogen fluoride, a colorless gas that's highly toxic and dangerous. EV battery recycling has been a major challenge to governments. According to material scientist Dana Thompson at the University of Leicester, current EV batteries are really not designed to be recycled. The BBC quoted Dr. Paul Anderson at the University of Birmingham in UK as saying that only 5% of lithium iron batteries are recycled currently. Because the cells in the batteries are held together with strong glues that make them difficult to take apart, it's often cheaper for battery makers to buy newly mined materials than to use recycled ones. In China, it costs at least 8,500 yuan, which is about $1,300, to recycle 1 ton of lithium iron batteries, but the recycled materials can only sell for 8,000 yuan or $1,200. In order to save costs, smaller recycling plants use primitive manual methods to disassemble the batteries, which is extremely dangerous. Dana Thompson said that cutting too deep into a Tesla cell or in the wrong place can cause a short circuit, which can combust and release toxic fumes. And Cao Hongbing, a researcher at the Chinese Academy of Sciences, said that waste EV batteries still contain high voltages and may cause fires and explosions during recycling. This is what happened on January the 7th, when an explosion occurred in the factory of Hunan Bangpu Recycling Company, a subsidiary of CATL, China's largest lithium-ion battery manufacturer. It was reported that 182 firefighters went to put out the fire. In the past 6 years, Beijing has aggressively pushed for new energy vehicles. China has the world's largest EV battery maker and makes half of the total new energy vehicles in the world. In 2019, Chinese chemical companies accounted for 80% of the world's total output of raw materials for advanced batteries, according to data from Benchmark Mineral Intelligence. The reason that Beijing is aggressively advancing the EV industry is to gain a strategic advantage in its global competition. But the push to produce EVs actually has not made the country any greener environmentally. By 2020, the use of coal power still accounted for 71% of the electricity supply in China. Of the country's 7 power grids, 99% of the power of the Northeast power grid and South China power grid comes from coal. So when you burn coal to generate electricity to power electric vehicles and then have to deal with the pollution caused by the batteries, you have double the pollution. Mining the world's rare minerals on a massive scale to make zero-emission cars only to be powered by burning coal doesn't sound green to me at all. For the U.S. to follow China's lead in the EV drive is, in my opinion, strategically unsound and economically unsustainable. Addressing consumer safety concerns and implementing recycling programs will cost American automakers a tremendous amount of money, so this green initiative will eventually make all cars more expensive. I think people will figure it out very quickly. It only takes a major power outage, like the ones we had last winter in Texas, for people to figure out that it's more sustainable to have a gasoline car. At least you still have a car to drive and can charge your cell phones during a power outage. You can watch my previous video on the three major areas of technical competition between the United States and China, and on Tesla's troubles in China. Thank you. I'll see you next time.